Hello, welcome to a video I made about me and my friend's trip to the island of Mackinac that we did at the end of May. Mackinac Island itself is a small island on the northernmost tip of Michigan, across from the city of Mackinac City and St. Ignace, pretty much next to the Canadian border. The island is famous for being one, a tourist trap, and two, a very beautiful and scenic island. At first, I was thinking about getting a hotel on the island, but after looking at the price of said hotels on the island,
Oh my God, bro.
Oh, hell no, man. What the fuck, man?
Who invited this man?
Get your ass
we decided to instead try camping, preferably away from the rest of the tourists. As you'll soon find out, neither one of us knew much about camping, and the only things we brought along with us were clothes, a power bank, and two sleeping bags.
That's kind of small.
Nonetheless, I waited until after I ate dinner with the fam and picked up Robert, who would be accompanying me on this journey.
We're going to drive to Mackinac Island. Can't wait.
Since Robert just got off work, I drove first.
Yes,
Okay.
sir. 6 hour.
Hey.
Our first pit stop would be at Grand Rapids, 3 hours away, where we would stop at a local hotel. But first, we got ice cream.
Ice cream with timer. Wee.
Anyways, that night we watched some TV and then went to bed.
Boy.
Damn, boy. Damn, boy.
Wakey, wakey.
After a restful night, we headed out of Grand Rapids back onto the highway. We had another 4 hours to go, and this time Robert was driving. There wasn't much to look at on the way, unfortunately. Just trees and more trees. On the way there, we noticed we would be driving through the city of Gaylord, so we had to stop and look around, of course.
Gaylord.
Need a boy you can cuddle with me all night. Give me one, let me long, be my sunlight. Tell me lies, we can argue, we can fight. Yeah, we did it before, but we'll do it tonight.
It's not what it looks like. How'd I catch you lagging is bad.
Anyways, an hour later, we finally arrived at Mackinac City. Now all we need to do was buy tickets for the ferry, and we'd be there. Thankfully, I'm not broke yet.
Focus, it won't focus.
I can't believe how much they got.
The fishing town's
How
in
much
Mackinac
they got right
City.
here,
Yeah.
all through the island.
It does look European, doesn't it?
They don't take you as far.
Now that we were on the island, we didn't really have a plan of what to do, so we just started walking around. Our only plan was to sleep outside, but that would be in another 8 hours. By the way, everybody tells you how beautiful and scenic the island is, but what they don't tell you about is all the horse poo and pee lying in the streets. Seriously, the poop was bearable, but the pee would accumulate in puddles near the sidewalk where you would be walking. Otherwise, what was said about the island was true. It was really nice, especially since there were no cars around either. Since we had nothing better to do, we decided just to walk around and maybe find a good place where we could sleep the night.
Try not to get run over by some horses. Look at this guy.
Heading out of the main town, it started to become even nicer. Most of the island outside of the main town looked like this, so we decided to stop for a moment and skip some stones.
Oh!
Let's go. Oh, shit.
Okay, I got two.
I am really bad at skipping stones.
Okay, three. Here. I got a
And then we got bored, and we climbed this rock-looking thing. There's not much to say here, other than it was very serene and beautiful. And then Robert did this.
Whirlpool.
It's like coming from the top of the mountain. That's awesome.
Yeah. You can take a little drink. Oh no, you got your jacket wet. No.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
We also found the spot where we would spend the night. Can you try and guess where it is in this picture? Well, it's right here. We were hoping we could find a nice, flat, grassy area to sleep, but we were naive to the landscape of the island. We found a somewhat flat rock that was not visible from the road and decided that would be where we would sleep. After exploring the north area of the island, we headed back to the main town and moved inland to where the residents of the island lived.
Oh yeah. Alright. You wanna go to that White House?
And then it started to rain. And since we both refused to spend any more money necessary on this trip, we decided to just keep walking around in it. The lesser amount of tourists was nice. For some reason, my hip began to hurt, so we sat down here where the water looked very blue. After this, we headed back in town to find dinner, and after searching for something cheaper, we settled for a sandwich place for the low price of $25. After dinner, it started to get darker out, so we started to make our way out to where we would be sleeping.
That is until we have to figure out how we're going to sleep.
You have a hoodie?
Before going to where we'd be sleeping, we went on one last side quest to a cool spot that we had seen earlier.
He's coming.
It wasn't anything crazy, just a cool spot that I took pictures at.
So nice.
When we got down though, it started to actually become dark out.
Nighttime spoopy.
Okay guys, I don't know if you can see, I can't see anything, but we're gonna sleep here. That's the water right there, and this is just a rock we found. It's pretty flat. So we're gonna sleep here, and I'll message you in the morning. Night night.
Alright, good night.
Good morning. Good morning. Robert, what time is it?
It was a really rough night. Obviously, sleeping on a cold hard rock, we barely got any sleep. We passed a lot of time by talking about real life stuff, which got us to doze off for an hour or two. But the majority of the night, we spent awake, trying to fall asleep on that cold hard rock. And, to make things worse, the wind picked up during the night, meaning the waves were really loud. But, all in all, the experience was worth it.
There. Right there. That's where we slept. So, we have just woken up, and we're walking back to town. I think I got like a solid 3 hours of sleep.
I got 3.5.
At least 2. How much? You got 3.5?
Yeah.
Okay. Robert says you got 3.5. Any back pains?
No.
Okay. Yeah, I'm fine as well.
Some of the prettiest sights, though, were on the walk back into town with the sun rising and with the lack of other tourists. We were both pretty tired of roughing it, so we waited for the first ferry back into town so we could drive home. This video from the ferry was the last one I recorded, as the drive home after was pretty uneventful. All in all, I had a really fun time, and considering we winged the whole thing, I think we did pretty well. Hey, blow up. Understand how the fuck my plug talk. Pick him up in a space coupe, I don't let my plug walk.